episode of Sons of Anarchy, I think.
Oh, I was going to be an arc. And then it conflicted with something, and I didn't end up doing it. I was going to be on 10 episodes or something. But I didn't get to be a white Aryan supremacist. And then I would have had to kill myself. It's very hard to be a Jewish Aryan supremacist.
Well, they still picked Mr. Arkin.
Arkin, he's great. Yes, but yeah, he's only half Jewish, though.
Oh, is that
yeah.
So it's okay.
You can be an Aryanista. You can't be a full-blooded Aryan.
Well, congratulations on your nomination for Georgia O'Keeffe. It's a beautiful, beautiful show that you made there.
Thank you very much. Yes, she's a great artist. Jeremy Irons and Joan Allen are two brilliant actors. Even though it all kind of happened together in this mad jumble that I barely remember. And, you know, TV is a pretty fast thing sometimes. But just the opportunity to be with those two people on a subject that was really interesting to me was a fantastic experience. It was great.
And, I mean, Joan Allen really looks like Georgia O'Keeffe. It's amazing.
She doesn't in real life. We had a brilliant costume designer, Michael Dennison. It's just a fabulous guy. He's been nominated. When you get actors like Joan and Jeremy in a piece about somebody who's beloved, and we did this in New Mexico, and a lot of the people on our crew were from New Mexico, and they all knew Georgia O'Keeffe. So, literally, the quality of people that we got in many departments. Stephen Altman did our production design. He did our production design for a movie I produced called Gosford Park about 10 years ago. We just had the best people working on it. Yeah, and Joan is one of the best actors you could ever find. And she just immersed herself completely in this brilliant character. She's a great character.
What kind of approach did you have to making this program, a television program about photography and the beautiful stillness?
Well, a lot of it... Alfred Stieglitz, Georgia's husband, was a photographer. Georgia was a painter, although she appeared in his photographs. So there's this great kind of synchronicity going on between the two of them. At one point in the movie, he takes a vast amount of naked pictures of her that she thinks are just for their own sort of love album that he's making. And then he displays them for the entire world. She's totally humiliated and about 5 minutes later realizes with his help that she is, the next time she has an exhibit of her painting, she's going to be the most famous painter in the world, because what other painter have you going to see that you just saw them naked in every part of their body? So it's pretty really interesting story. For me, the challenge was it's a very emotional story about two people who loved and hated each other and could not have existed professionally or emotionally without each other. So sometimes you do a biopic about somebody. I did something with about Doris Duke and her butler, Bernard Lafferty, for HBO the year before with Susan Sarandon and Ralph Fiennes. And we had to, in the beginning I said, you know, what you're about to see, some of it's true, some of it's not true, you know, you figure it out. Because we had to make up stuff. I mean, we didn't really know what was happening between these two. We knew it was interesting, and the writer did a great job, and they were brilliant in it. In this thing, the more we were like the real Georgia and Stieglitz, the better we were. Because they had such a fascinating relationship. So we combed through their letters. We took everything we could, and we worked with the head of the O'Keeffe Museum and Foundation, Barbara Bueller Lyons, a brilliant woman. She would read through the script. Georgia wouldn't do that. He didn't say that. This is what it would be like. And whenever we got truer, it got better, and better for the actors. It's not always that way, because a lot of very famous people aren't really that interesting, but these guys were.
Yeah, they were like this powerhouse, and they were critical of each other's work, and you know, I could just imagine her going like, I thought you were into the Flatiron Building, you know, and not nudes, you know.
Well, and also he slept with 1,000 other women, which was a challenge for the relationship. And they couldn't end up living together. They spent the last 20 years of their marriage living about 2,000 miles apart, but still were connected, joined at the hip forever until he died.
Well, you connected us with them in this great program, and best of luck tonight.
Thank you. Yeah, I'm looking forward to being here. There's a lot of nice people here today.
Excellent. Thank you. So great to see you again.